the B-21, fly unmanned missions, and manned-unmanned teaming, loyal wingman, capability to introduces a wide range of new tactical possibilities. A truly paradigm-changing platform, the Air Force's new B-21 Raider stealth bomber will bring a number of new innovations to the battlefield. These include a new generation of stealth technology, AI-enabled data processing and computing, and modern weapons, targeting, and fire control systems. The bomber is expected to reshape stealth bombing attacks for decades to come. Alongside performing a wide range of missions and operating unprecedented technologies, the B-21 Raider will also operate drones. We are assessing the potential to introduce a lower-cost, complementary, uncrewed aircraft into the B-21 to provide an enhanced level of capability, Undersecretary of the Air Force Gina Ortiz told reporters at the announcement of the service's 2023 budget request. Often referring to the B-21 in the context of a family of systems, senior Air Force leaders have frequently said that the new aircraft will be capable of unmanned missions. This concept of operations could evolve in several ways, as it could involve preparations for having the B-21 fly unmanned missions itself, or operate groups of networked drones from the cockpit of the aircraft. This kind of loyal wingman capability, now progressing quickly through Air Force testing and development, enables a manned crew to control the flight path and sense a payload from the cockpit of the aircraft. This not only allows manned crews to operate at a safer standoff range but also enables operation of a forward node or sensor platform from which to conduct surveillance, test enemy air defenses, or even drop weapons when directed by a human. Through programs such as the Air Force's Valkyrie drone, the service has already demonstrated the ability of an F-35 or F-22 stealth fighter to fly alongside of and operate drones such as the Valkyrie. This greatly reduces latency by avoiding a need to route time-sensitive surveillance and targeting data through a ground station. The B-21's manned-unmanned teaming also introduces a wide range of new tactical possibilities, to include an ability to deliver a much larger weapons payload, increased dwell time over target areas, and conduct attacks over a wider engagement area. The B-21 is slated to enter low-rate initial production in 2023. Final testing and preparation has been underway for months at Edwards Air Force Base, California. The Air Force is requesting $1.7 billion to begin producing the aircraft, which will begin its first flights this year in 2022. The operational imperative focused on the B-21 long-range strike family of systems represents our preliminary efforts to modernize the strategic aircraft leg of our nation's nuclear triad, Ortiz said. Very little information is available about the state-of-the-art B-21 bomber as most of the program is black or considered highly secret. However, senior Air Force leaders have been clear that they expect the B-21 to be able to hold any target at risk, anywhere in the world, at any time. Officials have described the new stealth bomber as being key to the Pentagon's nuclear modernization program, itself a top priority for the Department of Defense and the Air Force, according to Randall Walden, the director of the Air Force Rapid Capabilities Office. Of course, the B-21 will be more than just a bomber. It will eventually be an optionally manned, nuclear-capable, multi-role strike and intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance (ISR) platform low observability, next-generation stealth technology. In other words, this should be an incredibly remarkable weapon system. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.